Hello, hello, hello. Welcome everyone to day two of Tata Steel Chess 2022. This is Sagar Shah and a warm welcome to everyone in the chat. I have with me the very wonderful Amruta Mokal. Hello, Amruta.
Hi, Sagar. Thank you for your introduction as always. And hello everyone in the chat, all the mods, all the people there, all the members, everyone.
Yeah.
Are you excited for today and what's your prediction?
Well, there are some interesting games and there are some games which have already come to an end. Very quick draws.
Yes.
But there are also some decisive results which we are going to go through. But first of all, the standings before the round began, we had three players on 1 out of 1. Jordan, Duda and Vidit. And we had another 8 players on half points. Half a point, and then we had three of them, Sam, Rapport and Grandelius, on 0. So this is how the standings were. And Amruta, on the first day, it was Vidit who performed amazingly well. He beat Sam Shankland.
Yeah, in the longest game.
Yes, that was the longest game of the day.
Everybody couldn't sleep and study. Okay.
And then we had Magnus Carlsen taking on Essipenko, which ended in a draw.
Mm-hmm.
It was a very exciting game as well. And now, today, on day two, one of the games that we are very excitedly looking forward to is Magnus versus Anish Giri.
And all of you do remember the wink of the eye.
For sure, for sure. So, let's go and check out this game. It is Magnus Carlsen having the white pieces, Anish Giri who's black, and guys, ready for some action. You know, there'll be a lot of questions coming your way. In fact, yesterday we had few of them saying that these commentary streams help me to understand openings very well.
Hmm.
And so we are going to focus a lot on different moves, and I'm going to ask you, and we are going to use the chat chess moves here so that you can give the answer and, you know, we can check it out. Okay.
And just before you begin, we have the first member for today. Swapnil Sharma has become the booster of Indian chess.
Oh, thank you so much, Swapnil. All membership money goes to a talented youngster every month whom we support. Yesterday, we had 35 new members, which was fantastic. So, d4 by Magnus. And yesterday, Magnus would have been extremely upset with himself because he could have won his game.
Yeah, the against, d4 move.
Against Essipenko, he had this d4 break. He did not take it. And then he must have felt like, why didn't I play it? And so now, today, he must have come all ready to for a great game. But his opponent is the super solid Anish Giri.
Yeah, so right now, also, he will be a little bit in a revenge mode because he's lost to him in the last game. So, Carlsen today, revenge with Anish, that's one thing, and yesterday is missing d4. Those are the two things which are going to kind of his attitude is going to
change. You are very right, because in World Blitz 2021, Anish managed to beat Magnus Carlsen. I was there watching the game from a distance of like 2 meters away. It was amazing. So d4 knight f6, c4 e6 was played, and now knight to f3. And he played the move d5. Now, Magnus played g3. And the first question to everyone here, what is the name of this opening? Oh, by the way, we have another member right
we
now.
We have Phoenix514 who upgraded his membership to Pillar of Indian Chess.
Oh, thank
which
you,
is the
Phoenix.
Highest one.
Thank you so much. That's very kind of you. And we also have
The third member.
Third member for today, d4 player, and that's exactly what has happened. And so many people have given the answer. It is the Catalan, absolutely right. Sanjan Nupune, Sarvendra Maheshwaran, no name, simply medic, Deven Tiwari,
Shiv Shom, Azim Khan.
You know, Amruta,
yeah,
why a player like Magnus is extremely dangerous when he plays this is because he is going to use the opening of his world championship preparation, because he was playing Catalan against Nepo there.
What an amazing point. I was wondering why g3 is going to be so dangerous.
Yes, here. Because he has all the lines like very well prepared. So let's see what Anish, because Anish was the commentator, official commentator.
So he is also going to be.
Yeah, so he must have definitely kept that in mind. He castled, and this is one of the main positions of the Catalan, starting positions. Now, there are two ways for black to deal with this position. One is he can play c6 or knight bd7, which leads to closed Catalan, or he can take on c4, which leads to open Catalan.
Mm-hmm.
Anish took on c4, and at that level, Amruta, top level, open Catalan is more popular because it's more free-flowing. And now, the main move in this position is queen c2.
Okay.
And then black can play a6 here. Mm-hmm. That is one of the ideas. And then white can either take or play a4. This is very popular. Or you can play as black the move that has suddenly become very, very important, which is b5, which Nepo played against Carlsen.
Right.
And now is another question, this time a chess move. What did Magnus play against Nepo in this position? It was game number 2 of the World Championship match 2021. Let me see if you guys remember it.
Whoa, that's a great memory, Sagar Shah. I thought it was a very, very tough trip and you would have forgotten most of the parts of it. At least, I mean, Magnus versus Nepo, yeah, so many games, so many moves. So...
yeah, but Amruta, we lived the World Championship. You know, we breathed in. Every move, we were sitting there analyzing. I know you were a little bit moving around, taking pictures, taking clips, a lot of things happening.
Yeah, you were taking care of chess, no?
So, let's just see whether our chat remembers or not. And we have it. Yes, fantastic. This is what I love about our chat. They remember things. And they know it. 95, Dipesh Sokhal.
Ekam Singh, Aditya Vag, Chest, Shubham Jagtap, Devamalya Sarkar, Shashank Ashwath, Adit Bansal, Shritu Patel and Shubham Deshpande.
Fantastic guys. That awesome. Was a move which had shocked everyone at that time because it was not supposed to be a very common idea.
So right now, Sagar, more than looking at the engines, all these people have a good memory.
Yes. Absolutely.
Yes.
They are very well versed with this and they remember it. But Amruta, now comes the surprising part of this game. Why is it surprising? Because let's have a look at our chess base database to tell you exactly the complete story. Because it's only the statistics which makes you understand what has just happened. If you see this position and if you see this on the board, the main move here, as I just mentioned, is queen c2. With 17,957 games.
Wow.
Then 5,000 games have knight e5. But only 578 games have continued knight a3. And Magnus plays knight a3. And the top grandmaster who's played it is Vasily Ivanchuk. And of course, Daniel Dubo.
Oh, there we have. There we have. Daniel, Magnus has not played this.
No, but Dubo has played this against Wesley So at the Magnus Carlsen Invitational in 2021, and the game is annotated in the mega database by Wesley So. So, well, interesting. But knight a3, Amruta, this is something which is not very common, and Anish now decided that okay, I must respond to this. He would have prepared, of course. He took only 2 minutes to take this knight.
So he was prepared.
Yeah, he just recollected his stuff and he took. Now b takes a3. Mm-hmm. So guys, can you tell me a few imbalances that have happened in this position? There are many, many imbalances. Imbalances, basically the differences in the position.
Mm-hmm.
So can you tell me what has just happened and who has what imbalance? Vatsal Makol says Anish helping Magnus to reach 2900.
Yeah, many of them.
But not yet, guys. Game is still going on.
So
yes.
Double pawns is one of the major answers, Sagar, we have.
Rudranshu Sen, you are right. No name says pawn islands.
Adit Bansal says, Horror Inside says white bishop pair.
Yes, of course, the bishop pair. Now, you see that if you look on the surface, you will see that white's position looks like a complete mess, Amruta. First of all, you have these doubled pawns. They are not only doubled, they are also isolated. Means they are all alone.
Hmm.
At the same time, black is a pawn up. But in return, you have the bishop pair.
And the open b file where there is already some pressure at the b7.
Right. Yeah. So open b file and kind of open position for your bishops. So Anish now played bd7 and he did so very quickly. So this was also his preparation.
Correct.
A4 by Magnus.
Oh, he stops b5 basically.
Yeah, he stops b5, but also Amrita, I think he's preparing bishop a3 to hit the rook from
nice
here.
Nice move. Yeah, a4 is a very nice move.
Bishop and now b6. Anish took 3 minutes, played bishop c6, which is all very logical. Bishop a3, you want to save your rook, so rook e8. And now came queen c2. So what Magnus is telling is that if I get this pawn, I would be better. Because then the material is equal and I would have bishop pair.
Yeah.
And in such positions, the double pawns, although they look ugly, as Amrita rightly pointed out, they give the open b file to white.
Yes. But I'm also thinking that white needs more than that. Like he needs to have some center control, like his e and d pawns. Otherwise, is it really going to be that kind of an edge?
Well, we'll see. So yeah. He went knight bd7.
Yeah.
And now one of the questions to our viewers is, why can't Magnus simply chop off this pawn? Why is this not a good move? Black to play. Why? What would you do? Shiv Shom says white pawn structure, white pawn down, white has bishop pair, white has better center, white has b file. Interesting. Everything from white's perspective. Huh? Well, we'll also go to Vidit's game, of course. But let's quickly first check this game because this is definitely one of the most exciting games of the round where Magnus Carlsen has managed to, he's playing against Anish Giri. But let's have a look at what our chat is saying. Fantastic. Again, you guys are absolutely right. So many of you have mentioned knight b6.
Shiv Shom, Mahesh S.A., Max Staff, Himika, Chessbro, Anmol Srivastav, Priyavrata Sinha, Pon Balaji, Indrajit Forever and Devan Tiwari.
Yeah. You know, Amrita, the thing is that after knight b6, you lose the pawn on a4. And this is exactly what Anish is looking for. So Magnus first says that I will not do that. I'll play rook ac1, improve my position a bit.
I think maybe a5, but
also seems logical to play this. But
b5, yeah?
Yeah, b5 controls both these pawns.
Black is simply a pawn up and I don't think white has enough composition. Because if I take on b6 right now, then ab6 or cb6 and you again save
no,
it.
No, this attacks.
And then you go b5 anyway. Got it.
So, he didn't play a5, he went rook a c1.
Anyway, knight b6 now, then you have a5.
Then a5, yeah. If you go knight to b6, then I'll push it away with a5. So, he went a6 and now Magnus took the pawn. So, at this point, Anish said, but Magnus, isn't your a4 pawn hanging?
Yeah, still.
So, he did this and he played queen to c3.
What? With the tempo? Knight a4 is with
yes.
the tempo, right?
So, his point is that if you take with the bishop, I can take here. That is one possibility. Okay. But also I can go knight e5, unleashing this bishop. So this was definitely possible to take on a4. Because even knight e5, Amrita c6 and the game is still quite complicated. Mm-hmm. Maybe Anish could have thought of playing it this way. But he took with the knight.
Knight e4 is very natural, right? You are attacking the queen. It's a tempo. And what's the problem here? I mean, that's the
well,
main question.
Not much. He played first queen b3.
Yeah. And now you go back maybe knight b6.
So, firstly, Amrita, he wanted to take here, pawn takes and win the knight. That was his idea. Now, if you go knight b6, here is my question to all of you. What do you think had Magnus prepared in this position? What was the plan that he was going for? I think I have no doubt that Magnus would have gone for that move here. So white to play, what would have Magnus done? You know, it's a typical Magnus Carlsen like move who, you know, he would take the risk and he would go for it. Yes.
You have got a compliment, Sagar, by Shubham Patil. He says you are looking like Magnus when he is drunk and screaming.
You know, today my parents had come home before the commentary, and my dad looked at me and said, why don't you shave? What is your problem? And I said, you know,
Amrita is my problem.
No, I said yesterday I took a poll on YouTube and they said not to shave. So I listened to
my... 43% said not to shave.
Oh, no, Amrita. 57 said not to shave.
No, 57 said to shave.
Really?
Yeah.
I think in my head some... Maybe it was like more percentage before.
And then
it turned out... Or are you...
Yeah, I think I'm sure. And then we decided that we should have a poll today again because they should get three options. One is a stubble also.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, anyway.
During this conversation, we have got a new member.
No. I don't think it was because of this conversation, but Shamika Dalvi, thank you so much for becoming a member. And fantastic job, all of you who have written Rook Takes C6, brilliant. Dhanay Doshi, Tushar Sanpal, Pawn Balaji, who is in 8th C, Ekam Singh, Crazy Content, Gaming Clips, Divyansh Nata, Shaibi Binoj, Himika, and No Name. You guys have got it right. I think Amrita Magnus would have sacked an exchange and he would have told Anish that now I will go knight e5 and I will take this pawn. I will have my two bishops looking at this position. But you know, Amrita, it's still not clear. And I think Anish could have gone for this. He could have taken the pawn on d4, allowing knight c6.
Bishop c6, queen
no,
e5.
No, e5 was hanging. And here it becomes quite interesting and complicated. There is knight e7 check in the air. The rook could be hanging. But it's
the only problem is when you have to play against so many active pieces, it's a little bit of scary. Especially with Magnus. I mean, you give him so many good pieces, no?
But you know, Amrita, he's already exchange up and a pawn up. So the best Magnus would be able to do is get back his exchange.
Hmm.
And then the position would equalize.
Hmm.
It's not like black is very passive. So therefore, I think it could have been a good idea to go back to b6.
Unless he has something better.
Right. But Anish played queen d5. And here Magnus Carlsen stunned his opponent. I don't know. You know, Anish took a lot of time, by the way. He took a lot of time on every move. It's not like... he took a lot of time for a6. He was 124. And he took 27 minutes. But now after queen d5, he once again took on c6.
Oh, really? So what is happening right now?
So because first,
if b takes c6 looks then
you,
natural.
No, then you take on a4.
But then if queen c6, there is already
you
knight.
You have to take queen c6. Because if you take queen b3, I will take b3 and
lost.
Take this.
Lost.
So you have to take back with this and
Anish... 95, yeah, naturally.
Yes, 95. That's what Magnus did. And now Anish said,
forest.
Yeah, I'm offering you a queen trade. I'm also defending my knight. So Magnus...
So the material imbalance is two pieces for a rook.
No. Exchange down, Amrita.
Still exchange.
Exchange down and pawn down. Count the number of pawns. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And black has 7. So you are not just exchange down, but you're also pawn down.
And the position, the computer says this is still equal.
Well, if the computer says this is equal, it means white is doing amazingly well.
Correct.
Because he's 3 points down, yet it says equal. So that's how you can understand that the position is tough for black. Now Anish dropped his rook, queen back, sorry, Magnus dropped his queen back to c2.
Mm-hmm.
And if you don't do anything here, Amrita, then already there are ideas of rook b1 trying to snatch this.
Yeah, and the black queen looks a little bit like in trouble because after rook b1, I would say a5 looks like the only square.
Yeah.
And then bishop b4.
Yes, it's already very bad.
Yeah.
But here, I think Anish should have gone back knight b6. And
where?
Then if,
no.
if rook b1, then yeah. There is queen a4.
And then queen c7.
Yeah, so let's say here, but then a3 is hanging.
Hmm.
So maybe you
so
want
first
to take
queen c7.
c7
then you have rook c8 and I give you activity as well.
I was thinking maybe knight d5, but then no. There could...
queen f7 check.
Ah, this is hanging. So
rook c8 is also not coming. What a miss. What a blunder.
Yes, this is hanging here. So let's put our knight back and offer an exchange here, and if you take here, I will go and back with my queen.
What about bishop takes b7 here? No, but
then rook a7 should be big trouble. So, I think Amruta, somewhere Anish could have held his own by going back, but he played knight d5, which was a massive mistake in the position. Yes,
this
turned out to be a big, big error. And here, first move that Magnus played was rook b1, which is very natural, hitting the queen. So this Anish would have seen, you know, for sure.
Because it's forcing. Queen a5 is also forced here. And what about e4, simply?
Well, if you play a move like e4, then my knight would jump to c3.
Bishop b4?
Huh.
Finish.
Really?
Yeah. Because if you can make the moves, there's a discovered, you know, there.
e4, knight c3 and bishop b4.
Yeah, knight c3 is finished. Queen b5, then bishop takes c3 is discovered attack.
Yeah, that looks very bad.
So, e4, you cannot play knight
c3. I have
to
go here.
So, it's in control. So, there was a better idea than e4. That
and then this here, I may have to go here. And if you take here, then I have to take here. And you have two pieces for a rook, but it's still playable.
But you know, Amruta, better in long term. Over here, what's the winning move? That is something we should try to find.
Magnus here came up with a very interesting
this
idea.
This happened in the game, yeah?
Yeah. So, white to play, guys. What would you do in this position? White to move. Black is somehow surviving. He's on the edge. Amruta did suggest the move.
I found it. I mean, it's very easy, actually. But everybody will find it.
Hima Aishwarya says, what did they actually play? Try to think here. What did Magnus Carlsen play here?
But this last few moves kind of had a lot of very clear calculations, right? Very crystal clear calculations and very tactical, I think. Just the last few moves.
Yeah.
Very sharp.
Yeah. Well, you know, Amruta, somewhere now you have to... You can't even go queen c3 because this is hanging.
Correct.
So, let's just have a look at what the chat is saying. We have bishop takes d5, which is the move that Magnus played. But we have also knight c4.
My move was knight c4. Yeah.
We also have rook b7. And we have bishop e4, which is the strongest move of the engine.
Bishop e4?
Yeah, which is kind of
crazy.
Goes above my
crazy,
head.
Crazy.
But let's have a look at, first of all, knight c4.
Yeah. Because queens, what? Queen
no,
c3?
No, but the thing is, now look at this. Queen c3.
Queen e4.
Take.
B5.
And b5. And you lose back your piece. So you can't play knight c4, guys. Knight c4 would lose in this position. That is what Anish also might have seen. Now, all those who are saying bishop e4, hats off to you if you haven't used an engine.
No, how can you find bishop a4 without engine? Come on.
No, this is hanging. It's no, like you are attacking there.
No, you can't find it. I don't think
well,
you can find it.
Oops, sorry. Not g5. g6 is possible. But then, it doesn't... It's like, you know, now after provoking g6, you take on d5.
And what then, happens in knight g4 or something? I mean, is it the f6 and h6 weakness you are...
No, yeah, it's just fighting that these are weaker now,
so
and you can't play f6 because knight g6 hangs. So
Magnus played bishop
no,
e4?
No, he didn't play. He
if
didn't
Magnus play. Didn't play Sagar, whoever has said bishop e4, it is not possible to find
well,
that in 2 minutes. I cannot believe it.
True, but it was not an easy move. But I think one of the things which we request all of you is try to think on your own. Put the moves in the chat which you think and try to learn from this, try to improve. Because that is the best way. Try to avoid using any external help. Now, bishop d5. If you take with the queen, then a4 would hang. So, he took with the pawn here, Amruta. But it turned out to be an error. Because even if he took with the queen, queen takes a4. And in this position, after f6, the position is still playable. You know, a2 is hanging. Anish has already one pawn, right? He would get another pawn. He would have rook and two pawns for two minor pieces.
Yeah. A little bit difficult it becomes for white when he doesn't have a chance to create a easy passer.
Right.
That's why. But long term advantage, of course, two pieces he has.
But I think Anish thought to himself, why not take with the pawn?
Hmm.
Now I'm exchange up, correct? And he cannot win a piece with bishop b4 just as yet, because I will go queen b6. And if you take here, then I can take on d4, but also I can play f6. And the reason why this move is very, very strong is because after the knight moves, there is a5, and then you lose this.
Oh, that's why you don't play queen d4, because you have a better way. That's yes. what I was wondering, yes. why to not go for.
Well, you can even go directly a5, mm-hmm. and you can win this.
Yeah.
So, it is for this reason that queen b6 was, bishop b4 is not best, but look at what he did. He took on b7.
Oh, so now in one move, the queen is getting trapped. Bishop b4.
Oh, bishop b4 is definitely a queen trap, because the rook has gone inside the camp. You know, the rook was behind and now it has gone inside. So, bishop b4 will trap
There's
the
no
queen.
There's no time for rook b8. You have to make a...
But queen e1, check, Amruta. Check here. King g2 and then f6. Oh, then I take on c7 and it's a mate. Yeah, they go. It's like...
Oh god, it's so complicated.
No, it's not even complicated. It's just finish. If you do this, I take on c7 and it's over. So it's all about quality, you know, in life and also on the chessboard, a lot of it, there is always a discussion about quality or quantity. Here, black has the quantity because he has two rooks and a piece. White has rook, knight and bishop. So in a way, white has lesser quantity, lesser material. But look at the quality of his pieces. This bishop is beautifully posted. The knight is looking at so many important squares. The rook is on the seventh heaven. The queen is eyeing the c7 square. So it is quality that is helping here. And so Anish went for the move c5. Did he play this already? Oh my god. Look at this, Amruta. C5. And now guys, try to think. How did Magnus continue here? This is getting very nasty here. White to play. Rishikesh Panikar says, why doesn't a queen trade work? But how, Rishikesh? How are you going to trade the queen? Delight Daniel says, if I apply imbalance theory to this game, I'll lose my mind. Magnus did everything opposite to the norm. Not really, Delight. Actually, he just gave up material for activity. He said, the imbalance which I want here are active pieces, good pieces, and he gave up material for that. Look at this. And the chat has got it all right here. Queen to f5. Brilliant job by all of you who found this move. Fied. Supayan, Chess is Fun, Shaibi, Mistadam, Aryaman, No Name, Rohit B, Abhimanyu. Hello guys, sorry we are back. We almost did a commentary for like 5 minutes.
Maybe, yeah.
Or 2 minutes. Without
knowing what is happening.
Knowing.
Risky to not see the chat.
Sorry for that lag. I'm very sorry. In fact, what happened? We stopped at queen. When I said Amruta, queen f5 is when. So queen f5.
Yeah.
And he came here to take on f7. I'm sorry that it all went off. And we analyzed a lot. We said after rook d8, Magnus took here and Anish went back. Now, if you take this.
Rook
f5. If queen e6, we saw that there is queen f6.
Yeah, and the mate of knight f6, smothered mate, is not possible.
Guys, just refresh. It is working. Just refresh the stream. And by the way, d takes c5 is a tremendous move by Magnus Carlsen, Amruta. It shows so much confidence on your position. You just believe that you are winning.
Yeah, you have so much material down, but... Black can really do nothing. It's at the end, if you compare the activity of all the pieces, this rook with this rook, no comparison. Yeah, your queen here with this queen. Look at this knight. Okay, maybe we can say the knight and bishop right now. Let's put them.
No, Amruta, bishop is going to get active after c6.
Yeah, so for the moment, And then black has one extra rook to defend that way. Yet white is clearly crushing.
Yeah, white is crushing. And the main thing is that here, Anish now went for the move queen f6. And look at this. Look at what Magnus did. Guys, it's your move now. What do you play in this position? White to play. Try to figure out what do you play here as white. Yes, yes. I mean, you know, Amruta, all the conventional wisdom is being thrown out of the window here because it is said when you are behind in material, you should not exchange pieces, especially when you are attacking, you should not exchange queens.
And what does Magnus do? Exchange.
And Magnus does what our chat has told him to do here. Exactly the same. Oh, by the way, where did our board go? One second. Springing up the board here. Yeah. So he took on f6 and the right move has been suggested by Falgun, Shiv Shom, Abhimanyu, Raghavendra, Adit, Savite, Himanshu, Divyansh, No Name, and Shivam Kumar Acharya. He just went and he chopped off on f6.
G takes
f6. Check on h6. Now you can't go on the 7th rank because the rook is there. So you go king h8.
And now maybe just c6.
And c6.
Rook c.
Now this rook is hanging. And your threat is to take and play c7 and rook b8 to queen this pawn. So he went rook fc8. And now Magnus is thinking for his move. Amruta, is it like very clear that Anish is losing this? I mean, the bar shows like complete advantage to white.
Maybe very specifically, let us try to just analyze for a moment. Right now, if you play c7, you still don't have an immediate threat, right? You have knight f5, knight d6.
Check and knight d6
check
also.
Check and knight d6 is better. True. So king g7, now that you have... Anyway, knight f5 is a check. No matter what, I'm getting that one tempo.
Yeah, also, if I could somehow get the bishop here and here, I'm winning. That's also a mate.
Oh, amazing.
That has happened. C7 has happened. Anish has played his knight to C3.
So now if you go bishop e7, he can maybe defend by...
King g7. Yeah. Because now it's no longer the 7th rank is controlled.
But anyway, what about knight f7 check and knight d6? Should it not be over?
Knight f7. Let's say
king g7. Knight d6.
Knight
maybe
d6.
We'll go knight a...
And let's say you go knight b5, attacking here and here.
Knight c8.
Take. I'll have c8. To take back.
And then your c7 is attacked.
This is hanging.
You don't want to lose that. I mean, do you?
Yeah, I'm just thinking.
Bishop b4, maybe you can't then take with the knight.
You can't take with the knight because of bishop a5.
But rook c7.
Rook c7, knight takes. Even this endgame is totally lost.
Oh, four isolated pawns for black. Yeah, it should be lost.
Pawn down.
But whatever advantage you had, you don't want to go into
this endgame. Yeah. Yes. So here maybe Magnus is thinking of a faster way to win. But what is that faster way?
Bishop b2, knight e2, check, king f1.
Sachin Ranade says, why not bishop b2 here, Amruta?
Same question of mine.
Because if you take here...
King f1. And then you cannot defend your knight on e2 and the one move mate on
it. But I can come out on g7 and attack your knight.
And I can give a check.
Okay, you can give a check. I have to come up.
Then I can give knight h4 check and then you...
Knight
e7 check is a fork.
Knight e7. Okay, that doesn't work. So yeah, this should
so
bishop
be bishop
b2
d4.
Seems...
No. For bishop b2, d4 would be your consideration.
Okay.
Yet knight f7 and then knight d6.
Knight f7, king g7, knight d6.
And now if you go knight b5, the difference is I am winning the d4 pawn also. Like knight b5, knight takes c8, rook takes c8. And a4.
Oh, Amruta in full flow here. And if you take here...
This endgame should be
take
easy.
Here.
Without...
take here and bishop d4, and with two pawns up, I think Anish can resign with a clear conscience. By the way, what we have said has not happened, I believe. He played the move. Oh, it happened. It happened. Bishop b2 did. Congratulations to everyone who thought of bishop b2. That is what Magnus Carlsen played. He went d4. Magnus then gave a check. King came up and knight d6. Exactly what we imagined. And now he's going to take on c8. And then he's going to win one more pawn when he will be two pawns up. And I believe that Anish can right now resign, yeah?
So maybe play a few more moves, no? A little bit.
Unknown says rooks on a8 and c8. Exactly, you know, this rook hasn't made a single move. And it's just like somehow Magnus has used his pieces.
So if you compare the whole game where we were considering him as an exchange down, just remove that 8 rook and all the while he was a piece up.
True, the rook did not do anything, and also the knight is supercharged. Yes. It's jumping from here and there, and it jumped like anything. I don't even remember like, from where it went. Oh, so the knight
it
was
might be
here.
Was crazy.
Cray cray. Knight went here first to e5, correct?
Hmm.
Wasn't it that knight?
Yeah, knight f3 ka e5 pe gaya. Hmm. Then it went to f7. The journey was very short, but as you say, yeah, very, very energetic.
Ah, yes, yes, yes. So from g1
not like yesterday is with its
to
knight,
e5. Which,
traveled
to f7 to h6 to f5 to d6.
Yeah. Shivsham says rooks on a8 and c8 are a reflection of lockdown life.
You know, at such moments, you are thinking to yourself, should you resign here? Should you play on? It's not an easy decision to make.
How many people would have continued the game and how many would have resigned? Let's say opponent is not Magnus.
I think no one should resign in general. But when you are playing against Magnus...
At which point, you're saying? Because at some point, you're dead losing and you still keep playing and playing. And then there is a quote, better player knows when to resign.
There is a quote which says, no one has ever won a game by resigning. And there is a quote which says, better player knows when to resign. And you know, if you keep reading quotes all your life, they will constantly keep contradicting each other. And it's so bad. You know, Amruta, once I was like in college and I was thinking about writing about this, like I had this thing that strike the iron when it's hot. I was like, oh man, this is my chance. I should do something. And then next day you see patience is a very big virtue or something like this. And then you question yourself, what exactly needs to be done? I think it all depends on the situation.
Absolutely. And but I'll say most of the people here want to continue. So that's a good thing. Definitely continue. As I would feel I'm better as I'm material up, Shashank says. Let's not forget it.
Oh, by the way, yeah, Anish has only 2 minutes.
And how many moves?
You know, in some tournaments.
Ten moves.
Tournaments, and guys, all those youngsters who are watching this, don't do this. You know, many times they land up in such losing positions and then they sit there for half an hour.
Half an hour, 1 hour.
1 hour, and then they come out.
Look here and there, they do nothing,
and then they come out after 1 hour and and their parents think that they have sat for like 3 hours.
This was such a common strategy, oh my god, in the earlier days when the game was of 7 hours. I can't tell you,
because at that point many of the parents would want their kids to play a long game. It didn't matter if they won or lost. By the way, Anish has gone king g6.
Himil Patel says, but how to know which code to apply where? I think like in chess, so many times your intuition develops after playing a lot of games.
Yeah.
Like that in your life, your intuition will develop for life.
I guess so, yeah. You should be able to apply it at the right time, at the right place. I think that's the difficulty. Because if it was as simple as just reading and gaining knowledge and then you could apply it, then it's no fun. But here it's like you have to gain the knowledge. And then you have to apply it at the right time. So king f1, Amrita defending e2 pawn. So there is no check. And Magnus is very calm about this. He's not in a hurry. Chesser, thank you for your super chat. Now, okay, one of what Anish wanted to do and is right is that the moment he brought his king away from the 7th rank, he can now move his rook away, like rook f8. Because now this queen does not come with a check. So that was one of his ideas. But I think here, what would happen, and maybe the cleanest way to win, would be to take, pawn takes, and now play this very classy move, king e1.
Is this the best way? Yes, and then you are getting only this. I mean, in comparison.
What you are getting only this. You have no move left. You can't come here. You can't come here. Your rooks are tied down. My knight is a monster. This pawn is just good. And I'm going come here.
True. That's true. But you know, Sagar, sometimes such a thing, when I used to play, you get such aggressive positions with your queen and all that you want to checkmate your opponent. You know, you want something so much more. Your expectation from the position is so high that what you do is generally, I'm telling you what was a common mistake.
Correct.
Would avoid queen exchange and then would land up in a messy situation.
But so I think Magnus understands that here he can win in this 100%. Calm way. He took. And now has played his pawn to a4. Just what you said. What you mentioned has happened.
That one. Yes. Knight c7 and takes bishop d4.
He takes on c7. Anish is maybe wanting to play
until... No, so the game is going to go on. Because if you go bishop d4, you're...
No, why? Now you don't resign.
Now you don't resign.
You're 2 points down.
Yes, but there is chance to go into rook, bishop versus rook endgame.
What? How?
If Magnus goes wrong.
I don't think.
But Magnus missed d4 yesterday. Anything is possible.
No, come on.
No, he won't resign.
Really? By move 100%. 40, he will.
Okay,
he will play until move 40. Yeah. It's move number 36.
Why don't you do a poll? Whether the game will end before move 40th or not.
Okay, let's do it. I think it will end on move 40. Well, the moment Magnus plays 40th move, Anish will be like, okay, that's done. Okay, the poll is up, guys. Try to see if you can make your vote right. She makes me do work which is not at all necessary.
I like how much you trust me.
What I trust you? In what way?
You put the vote and everything, no?
Yeah, he resigned.
And he resigned. Anish resigned.
Yeah. So Anish has resigned. What a great game this was, actually. Yes. Full credit to Magnus Carlsen for finding some amazing moves. But I think Anish would be very, very unhappy with himself for playing knight d5 here. Because that is a move that you cannot excuse yourself. And it's not even like that is the only, he could go back knight b6. And I think that is where Anish would be like, why did I play that move?
Yeah, the position was still very complex here and very sharp, I would say. Sagar, it's just a matter of only 4 or 5 moves those were, but yeah. Super sharp.
Yeah, it was a very interesting and exciting game until this point. But unfortunately, after knight d5, Magnus brought his rook. Then he took on d5. Here, again, taking with the queen would have prolonged it, but he took with the pawn. And now rook b7. And you know, Amrita, the interesting thing to note is that you can't even try to exchange off this active rook because your king is weak.
Oh, not bishop b4, yeah?
Yeah, because bishop b4 could be possible. But I can take and try to fight this. Okay, it must be bad.
This is also winning.
Okay. This should be winning, But queen f5 is such a classy move. And you know, guys, this is one thing, remember always. If your opponent's queen is slightly away from the king, and like here, it has no way to reach back. It's like there is complete obstacles in its path. Then queen f5, like look at this, rook b7. If you play rook b8, then queen f5. And then if you go f6, then here is a move for everyone to find white to play and finish off your opponent. Very beautiful.
Nice, super nice.
Akshay Natu, who's been a member for 14 months, one of our first members on this channel, coming back to this live stream is like homecoming. Well, thank you, Akshay.
Ashish Ghorpade, super chat says, hello Amrita Tai, and can you please say hi for Sanvi Kulkarni, Aryan Godbole, the like chess. Hi Sanvi Kulkarni and Aryan Godbole, it's great that you guys like chess, keep playing.
Yeah, hi guys, and you seem like very young right now, and I think in a few years you will become very strong, so all the best. And look at this, people want to play queen d7. This is what
was my blunder.
This is what chat has come up with. But there are a few who are very strong, and they are Kaustav Bhattacharya,
Mridul Rao, B. Jidov, Mohit Kumar Jha, Arpit 11, Aman Singh, Harsh Malu, Rahul Khatwani, Tarun Bansal, and Johan Van Vriebel.
Yes, and they have got it right. Queen e6 check is the correct move. You sacrifice your queen to get a check. The king has to come up. Can't come up. So the rook has to go back. And it's a mate.
Oh, my variation was different. My variation was rook takes b8 first.
Here?
Yeah, rook takes b8. Now queen e6 check, king h8. And then that smothered mate.
You wanted to do smothered. Ooh, yeah. Okay. That's also pretty. Also, you can go back rank like knight d8 and queen e8. But you know, smothered mate is everyone's favorite.
Yeah.
If king f8, queen f7, if king h8, then keep this in mind. You sack your queen and...
Yeah.
What a mate. Okay, so that ends the game. And now let's go to Vidit versus Karuana, which had actually been completed, Amruta, before.
Vidit is draw. So let's go to Pragnanda's game because it's going on and must be time pressure.
Okay, let's look at Pragu's game.
Four moves left and Pragnanda has 2 minutes.
Oh, Prag has only 2 minutes left and he's playing against Jan Sistov Duda. The position looks very exciting. In fact, the engines say it's equal, but I get a feeling that white looks slightly active, you know, Amruta. H5 is on the card, the rook is on the cards, the rook is very active on b8. Looks like a very good position for Prag.
Yeah, again, the piece activity for white is tremendous. Okay, but he has very low time. How much does it matter in this position, having 1 minute?
Someone said to me, you can't go king f8. Soham Sawant, yes, because there was a bishop there, so you could not play in the match.
Oh.
But okay, coming back. Here, Prag has to make 4 moves in 1.5 minutes.
So, what are the moves which come to the mind?
Okay, very difficult. Maybe h5 is one move. Sorry, h5. Exchanging the queens does not make sense because after take, rook d5, the pawn is stopped.
How is the move rook d8? But then knight e6, just a tempo, nothing much.
I was also thinking just queen d4. Oh, he goes queen e4, Amruta. And maybe on his mind is rook b7. Oh,
queen e4 is a nice move, like the move.
Now Duda has 35 minutes. In such times, you know, Amruta, when I had more time than my opponent, I had this very weird feeling. I don't know if anyone else in the chat has it.
Uh-huh.
I used to feel stressed.
Really?
Yeah.
I know. Because you had the hope that you want to beat him in his time pressure. Like, correct?
I don't know why, but I felt like generally when I had time pressure, I would feel nervous. And when I had more time and my opponent had time pressure, I would feel nervous.
Did you feel more nervous? In which situation?
When I had time pressure, but when opponent had less time, I would feel like, oh yeah, let me take some advantage of it. Even though I had read many books which would say never ever play on opponent's time. Try to find the best move, because if your position is better, you will anyway win. Why do you win? Want to win? And there were so many times when my opponent had very little time and I would make a mistake.
So that's where I understand, because I used to play all the games with 30 seconds increment, right? I used to always be under time pressure. My opponent would have so many minutes, hours, whatever you say. So they may be feeling nervous and then they would make a mistake.
Yeah.
In my time pressure. Interesting.
By the way, Paki Tewari has said, feeling sad for Anish, says, and Hale Carlson. And Arshad84 says, Sagar bhai, please try to invite Karpov in a stream. Almost every grandmaster has come on yours or some my stream. Even Kasparov has come. Yeah, well, hopefully we will be able to get Karpov one day. He did come on stream Amruta somewhere where it had the highest viewership ever.
Oh.
1.2 million people watched it or something.
Wow.
He played against this guy who has like a chess outfit.
Mm-hmm.
And it was on Spanish television, I believe. That's what, but I'm not sure.
Shivsom says, please check SC Penko Shark. Yes.
That ended in a draw. But we will check. Karyakin Dubov, which was supposed to be one of the very exciting games of this round because of what had happened at the World Championship. You guys know that Dubov was in Team Carlsen, and then Karyakin had said that Dubov, even though he's Russian, he's supporting someone who's playing against a Russian, and all of that stuff happened. Today they both faced off against each other, but they quickly drew.
Yeah, no entertainment. Shashank asks a question, Sagar. Sagar, how is it that Prag gets so much under time pressure given how much bullet and blitz he plays? I observed this in World Championship and Grand Chess.
That is true. I think Pragnananda has this time pressure issue, which he thinks a lot often, but he's also able to play very fast when he's not, when it's a smaller time control game. So it's like his mind tells him it's classical, so you think well, and he comes under time pressure. But when it is not a classical game, he can play aramse.
Which is a great quality, because you know there are players who are very good blitz players only.
Yeah.
You cannot really play well in classical because you cannot adapt to that thing.
But you know, Amruta, somewhere I do get a feeling that Prak is very, very serious, you know, about his chess and about his preparation, because even though he had a chance to play World Rapid and Blitz, he did not play it in Poland at this year end in December 25th to 30th. He was preparing for Tata Steel.
Exactly. I mean, imagine the type of practice, right? You, for blitz, world level, you have to play so much blitz, bullet, and your whole preparation is in another direction. And you don't want to miss such a chance of playing a classical event where that affects.
Acha, you think that that would have affected, but you know, there was 15 days in between. So I don't think that was the reason why he didn't play.
No, I think it will get affected for sure. 15 days is not enough, no? To play, if you want to prepared against these top grandmasters, the preparation was so crazy.
Yes, I understand. That is the reason that he wanted to prepare more. But I don't think that playing blitz and rapid would have affected his game, and that's why he didn't play.
Maybe one interview after the event. This can be a good question.
Yeah, sure. We'll ask him. But right now, Queen E4 and Duda is actually thinking what to do. Now, let's have a look at the imbalances very quickly. The imbalance is that Pragnananda has four pawns on the king side against Black's three. There is a queen side majority for Black. So that is the biggest imbalance. You can see that the knight is slightly passive but has a very good square on e6 to go to. e5 pawn is actually very good pawn for white because it's defended by the knight.
At the same time, could become a weakness. If, and the knight on f3 is tied down for the defense because it cannot move.
Right. But e6 has to be watched out for. Also h5 here. So all in all, you can say that if the queens come off the board, this position could be easier to play for black.
Yeah.
Because he has more endgame like trumps.
In fact, I would say if the queens are off the board, black is better. I can also say that.
Well, slightly. Not 100%.
No, slightly.
Maybe, yes, you are right. Because
in Alapin also, such a kind of structure comes from black. And this is a very good scenario there.
So let's say if I go b5, I'm just trying to make a random move. And if you play queen b7, and if I take and you take. Now, you have exchanged the queens. And let's a5. Say after a5. You have the queenside majority, but I think the only thing that is an issue here is that white is very active. So he would go knight d4. He's now threatening e6 move.
Yeah, because the pawn is on b5. No?
And then when you take here, I will take here and it could end in a draw.
Correct.
So this is what could happen. But Duda has played his knight to d7 and this is what is very interesting about Duda. He takes his chances, you know. He is a very ambitious player because he's now attacking the rook and also the pawn. What do
and,
you do?
And he's allowed that pin by
yes, and that has happened. Prag has played rook d7. He's pinned the knight on d7 and he's also attacked the pawn on a7 here.
Oh, I would never, you know, dare to allow such a pin.
But he's calculated it.
Yes,
and he's played sure. Queen e6. That was the only move in the position, Amruta, to come out of the pin.
Just for example, a move like a5, yeah, instead of queen e6. Just, are you losing with queen g4 here? Or queen d4.
Queen d4 attacking here and this is hanging. Okay. So that would not have worked. So he played queen e6 in this position. And now Amruta, I believe that this will...
Now e5 is hanging.
Peter out into equality. Let's say I take here. You take here. Maybe rook takes is possible. But I can also take with the queen. And then 4 versus 4 will end in a draw.
That's a very simple... Very simple draw.
You know, guys, I'm going to show you, I'm going to give you a small one game to remember forever.
Forever?
Yes, you have to remember this. It's a beautiful, beautiful game. It is a very famous game. I'm going to pull it out. Let's see. Until then, Amruta, you can read the chat.
So, one of the thing in question in chat, super chat, has Arshad84 asked, Sagar Bhai, why do people place Fisher above Karpov in top 3, as Karpov was number 1 for 10 years, number 2 for another 12 years and completely dominated chess.
Yeah, that is true. But you know, the way Fischer has had risen to the top, the way he dominated players like Taimanov, he beat him 6-0, Larsen, he beat him 6-0, then Petrosian, he beat like 4.5, 1.5, and then also he beat Spassky. I mean, that entire
journey. I mean, without
journey.
Much resources, right? We can say basically also, like, because in Soviet Union there, they had all the support.
Yes.
Whereas over here.
Absolutely. I mean, the entire thing, the entire Fischer story is so inspiring that he went against the system and he... like the entire Soviet system, and he beat all of them and took the title and all that Cold War back then. I think it makes him into an absolute legend. Yes, and of course, Karpov is another great and legendary chess player. But his reign was more peaceful, you know. He dominated for 10 years. He beat Korchnoi twice. And also at the same time, he won every single open tournament that he played in that period almost. So he is also amazing. But then when Kasparov came, he beat Karpov for 5 world championship matches, almost like 85, 87, 90. And, you know, he beat him in all those matches. And then you start to feel like, okay, you know, Karpo did lose, while Fischer didn't lose any match, he just quit from chess. So those are little things, little differences that could. By the way, Amruta, we were absolutely right as to what has just happened. This exactly has happened. After rook b7, queen e6, he took on a7, took here, queen e5, and we can expect a handshake pretty soon.
Yeah, from even the 40 moves are over, so no doubt.
But guys, what I wanted to show you was this. Now, are you ready for it?
Yes, before that, I'm going to read something. Sachin Ranade says, watching this stream in the car when wife is shopping, good use of my time.
Oh.
Sachin, now is your memory test because Sagar expects everybody to remember this game forever.
Yes, and I think Sachin will remember because when you are watching it in such a weird location, you will remember it. I'm like, oh, that was the game that I saw in the car.
Better. Yeah, connected better.
So what happened was that Prag went d4. This is known as cd, knight d5, e4. This opening is known as semi tarash, take take, okay? And then black is now low on space. White has a beautiful center, so black player says, bhai main to check dega. So then he says, okay, I'll exchange bishops because I have less space. I need more space for my remaining pieces. He castles. Now you have to decide where to put your bishop. Your bishop can be well placed here. Your bishop can be well placed here. It can also well be well placed here. By the way, Pragnananda's game has ended in a draw. But bishop c4. Now you play knight d7. You go castles. You go b6. And now the way in which you put your rooks is very interesting, because there are two semi-open files and you feel like you should put your rooks there, or one open file and one semi-open file. But the point is, you want to push in the center. So you put your first rook here,
mm-hmm,
and you put your other rook here. Okay. Now, if you remember this opening setup,
mm,
now let's go to the game that I want to show.
Okay, this is not the game you have to remember forever.
No, this one was Pragnananda's game. And based on that, I'm going to show you.
I'm sure many people got confused. So they will remember that also.
Are you Amruta? So this one is the game that I wanted to show. And actually, I'll show it in someday in Learn From Classics as well. Because it's an absolute classic. The white player is Lev Polugaevsky. Black is Mikhail Tal. And this is how it went. Same opening. Mm-hmm. Take, 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 take. Okay? People can see it. Check was given by Tal. Polugaevsky took here, castles, bishop c4. And here the only difference was knight d7 was played and then b6 in Prague game. Here knight c6 was played. Doesn't change much. Rook a d1, rook f e1. All good?
Good.
Okay. Now knight went to a5. So he played bishop d3. Now came rook to c8. Now he has all these weird ideas of knight c4. And black is sitting very pretty because, you know, like after you take, take, he has this bishop nicely placed and the rook is here. The queen is nicely looking in the center. So what is the move that black should play in this position, guys?
No, no, black played rook c8.
Ah, sorry, white to play. White to play. What is the move white should play in this position? Yes, we'll go to Tata Steel Challengers as well next and see. Oh, today also none of the Indians lost. Prag draw, Vidit draw, Arjun won, Surya draw.
Oh, all over, okay.
Oh, look at our chat. They are always so good. Amruta, this time, you know, they might not even be looking. They don't know, even know this game.
No, no, totally.
So, d5. Oh my God. How did you guys get this? By the way, this is not the board. Let me change the board here and get the... Yeah, this is the board.
No, even last time, there were people who were like, how can we not get bishop e4 when we want to attack at certain point? That way, yes. But the idea of bishop e4 provoking g6 and then taking on d5, that I should have mentioned. You can't get the idea. Not the move.
Okay. वत्सल मकोल,
निखिलेश प्रभाकर, यश तिवारी, सुकेश कुलकर्णी, आदित्य बंसल, अभिमन्यु सिंगला, शुभम देशपांडे, बुधदित्य भट्टाचार्य, मिस्ता दम एंड शिवम चौधरी.
You know why this game is special? Yes. The game is special because with the black pieces is the legendary Tal who loves to attack, and Polugaevsky sacrifices a pawn against him.
That's so, a very important one.
Yes. So, and the point is that after you take on d5, he's not going to recapture. Because if he recaptures, let's say if you recapture like this, then okay, yeah, maybe take, this is not anything great. I mean, black is doing completely fine. So what he did was he pushed his pawn to e5. This is a typical pawn sacrifice. So he came.
And you have applied the same theme so many times, right, in your games?
Yes.
Because of this game. Was
no,
it?
I mean, there are many games. But now look at this. He went queen f4. Okay. And now Tal was like, Polugaevsky, what are you doing?
Are we looking at Greek game?
Knight by, b2.
Oh, there is a Greek gift, right? Bishop h7.
He took.
Yeah.
King takes. He gave a check, Amruta. And now it's very clear that if you go back on g8,
yes,
I will go queen h4 with the idea of queen h7.
You know, Sagar, you had made me learn from Daniel King's Greek gift. And this was one of the positions.
It was there?
Yes.
Okay. Well, Daniel King is amazing, and if you guys have not studied Power Play series of Daniel King, please do it. It's one of the best. King f8 and e6.
Oh, no.
And this is over because now I have a threat of e takes f7, I have a threat of queen h8 check. It's too much to handle. Okay, so here he couldn't go king g8, so he played king g6. So now Tal was like, my king is out, I'm attacking your knight, I'm attacking your rook. And so the question to all of you here is, what move did Polugaevsky play in this position? It is white to play. Let's see how much in the chat. How many in the chat? How many people can find this? Yash Tiwari says, feeling proud. Nice, Yash. Keep it. Come on, find this move. This is not easy. Chess Brilliance knows this game, yeah?
Arsha 84 asks, your top 10 favorite chess players.
Okay, Amruta. You can say one, I can say one.
Magnus Carlsen.
Vishy Anand.
Okay. Gary Kasparov.
Capablanca.
Tal.
Smyslov.
Petrushin.
Many, but let's say Kramnik.
Yeah. Bobby Fischer.
Yeah, that's 10.
Huh?
We said 10, right?
Oh.
But what happened? It's okay, no?
I missed one name.
Who?
Sagar Shah.
What is this? Everyone from that list are like, we are leaving the room. We are going away. We don't want to be in this. Okay. By the way, what? No. Come on, guys.
Amazing. No, it's possible. You have taught in your, improving your chess. Greek gift.
I know, but h4 is such a tough move.
No, it's a pattern. It's a pattern. It's a very tough if you know move. Greek gift, then you know h4.
Okay, guys. Amazing. If you found it, if you saw it, not good. Please don't see that game. Ramakrishna. But if you knew it already, then great. You knew the game.
Yeah,
Abhimanyu Singla, Deepak Kanan, Devan Sharma, Mista Dam, Rohan Balasubramaniam,
Mridul Rao, Ashish Sharma, Janak Rajpurohit, and Mohit Kumarja. No, Sagar, this game, what to say? I mean, the idea really, it's possible. You've taught it even in improving.
So look at this, h4. Now this knight is controlled. So the question is, what happens if you take here on d1? Why is this not a good move? Because on the surface, it looks like it should be possible. Right now, you have taken here. So then you should be able to find this.
We have a new member, Gargeya RRS. Welcome to the backer of Indian chess.
Thank you, Gargeya.
Thank you. And Kingpin says, reached 1094 week back. Thanks.
Oh, that's congratulations.
Great. Congrats.
And by the way, Amruta, the move here is h5 check.
Not remembering. Okay, let's see what happens.
King takes h5. And now comes the deadly move here. And I want the chat to guess it. Guys, this is your chance to beat the great Mikhail Tal. Can you find the winning move here? Naveen JJ, well done. You found it. It's like, how do you say? Amruta, have you ever played this thing in childhood where, you know, you hold your hands like this?
Mm-hmm.
Can you hold?
Mm-hmm.
Like this? No. One hand here, the other hand here, like this, and then you run like. Have you played that?
Yeah, I don't think it's a game.
It's called Fugdi.
Yeah, but that is what many of the girls used to do it. But why would
no,
you
not
do
girls.
That?
They would do it in all marriages or, you know, everyone. But the reason why I remembered Fugdi and was because, look at this. The king and the queen here play Fugdi. They go here. He goes here. Check.
Oh my goodness.
King here. Check. King here. Check. King here. Checkmate. Like they ran, no?
Is there any international audience here who can remember the word Fugdi? This is Fugdi.
Yeah, of course. I mean, not just that's for them. It's for everyone. The king here check, and by the way, let's see how many of you got this one right with g4. Brilliant, so many of you have got it right. 197 people got it right. Siva Prakash,
Tanush, Mridul Rao, Uday Doipade, Sarthak Shah, Yash Kandu, Abhishek Gupta, Janak Rajpuravit, and Priyansh Arora.
Yeah.
Awesome, guys.
You know, Amruta, there are different kinds of checkmates in chess. Like there is this Anderson's mate, and then there is this double bishop mate, and then no one knew about Fugdi mate until today. They all learned it.
So every day we are inventing. Yeah, yesterday was caller's mate.
Caller.
Yesterday,
yeah.
I think Solly, and then today we have Fugdi mate.
Yeah, and you can do Fugdi both sides. Yeah, like you can also do it from this side.
Mm-hmm.
Like this. But anyway, guys, this was not possible. So Mikhail Tal played rook c4. He couldn't take the rook, and then came h5 check in this position. Maybe rook d4 was stronger, but he went h5, king h6, knight f7, and then he gave a check. He played e6, and it was a phenomenal game, and it's very similar to right now. What happened?
I'm good. Okay, I'll read it. Have to add place Fugdi to Sagar Shah's wiki. Okay, that's funny, but don't touch that.
Who's that?
RGS Linger 10.
Yeah, please don't do it. Hi, it's not place Fugdi. I just asked Amruta if she played. Okay, and by the way, this happened, and then eventually Mikhail Tal had to resign here. Because his knight, Polugevsky's knight, was very strong. But nice game, right? It's
yes,
worth remembering.
Really, really great. And it kind of gives belief that you can consider this bishop h7 idea.
Mm-hmm.
Like this was, I would say, one of the most complicated position to give the Greek sacrifice.
Yeah.
Generally, it's much easier.
Correct.
So, it will really help to understand the patterns.
Sarva Jayan, this was the game that we just showed between Polugevsky and Mikhail Tal.
Manish Mathur, Super Chat Sen says, hello Mr. Sagar Shah, my both daughters are big fan of you. They learn with you calculations. Please say hi if possible to Anmol and Arohi.
Anmol and Arohi, thank you so much for following this, and all the best to your chess. And I'm very hopeful that you guys, that both of you will become very good players and become calculation monsters. Yeah, it's very important in chess. So all the best. By the way, after knight queen e5, Duda asked a draw. Prag said, okay, why not? And with this, Pragnananda has one out of two. And he has drawn his first game yesterday against Anish Giri. Today against Duda.
Amazing.
Great start for really little Prag.
Absolutely.
But of course, we all know how good he is. And by the way, just to very quickly take you through the moves that had happened. Prag played this way.
And Sagar, we have to check Shanklin versus Grandelis right now. Chinmay is saying that it is heating up big time because there's a sacrifice, queen sacrifice or something like that.
What?
So,
let's look at
maybe
it.
Maybe. Let's just have a look at 33 moves only and 4 minutes. Oh.
Oh.
Oh my god. Ooh. Really?
Sam Shanklin has sacrificed his queen, it seems to me. Just very quickly to see where. So, this was a normal position. Like, not normal, but takes here, knight f5, rook g1, queen d7, king h2, queen d6, bishop g5, knight d4, king g2, b5, he went knight c3, b takes c4, d takes c4, queen e6, queen d3, rook d7, rook d1, rook f7, check, king here, rook d8, he went here, and now knight came here, rook b3,
ooh. Whoa!
Oh, nice. He just gave this up and he got a rook. Oh, he sacrificed his queen. He got a rook and a knight. But Amruta, what a knight this is. This is a nightmare. It's beautifully positioned.
Yeah. And the 7th rank, the king. Oh, wow. This is such a creative sacrifice.
Yeah. And also, like, if you now take here, I'll take on g5. There is a check and I'll
family
win this.
Fork. So you can't even think of it.
Yeah. Four
but what, how do you progress right now? What do you play right now? Maybe rook.
Rook d8. There's queen c4. Oh, Amruta, there is. Oh, Amruta, how about rook d7? Because if you take, I take.
Mm-hmm.
And if you take here, I have knight f6 check, winning the queen.
But after takes, takes king. Yeah. Isn't it a finish?
It looks very strong. Rook d7 is amazing because if you play bishop g5, there is takes, check, and you lose the
maybe
queen.
Maybe you can show them the variation after rook d7, that one which you showed.
So rook d7, here, queen d7, knight f6, check, and done.
And if king moves in. Once again, if king g8, you have knight f6 check.
Oh, by the way, he played rook d5. You wanted to check that?
It's okay. Yeah, I was looking at king g8.
But I can take here, no?
Check. Bishop, queen takes, anyway, still the same thing. And if king g8, there is bishop f6. Or no, am I wrong?
Yeah, maybe. But I can also just go back. Or I can play knight f6, threatening rook h7 mate.
Hmm. So rook d5.
So he played rook d5. There is queen a6 in the position. And now 1 minute 23 seconds for Nils. 3 minutes 57 seconds for Sam Shanklin. How to continue? By the way, Sam Shanklin is amazing at calculations. We all know that he is really good. Yesterday, Vidit managed to beat him in an endgame. But when it comes to hardcore calculations, he's really, really good. And a lot of his calculation improvement happened because of working with Jakob Augard, who is a great trainer and also an author.
Yeah. And, in fact, Sam has also written 2 books, right? On the pawn structure, is that right?
Yes.
Related
with... Yes, he's on pawns. Small steps to giant improvement. Queen a6. And now the question is, where do you... Yes, Aki's channel has said... we should start streaming earlier. Maybe guys, from tomorrow we'll try to come a little earlier.
Sure.
Also, a lot depends on who has the white pieces. You know, if today Karuana Vidit, it was Karuana who had white, we might have witnessed a longer game.
Mm-hmm.
Because... Today, I mean, Vidit was happy with the draw. with white pieces, and Caruana was happy with black, so it ended quickly. Also, Prag was white here.
Also, what is tomorrow's pairing? We don't know, but if the chat knows, they can let us know. So, what are the moves here? First natural move comes to the mind, knight of six check.
Oh, he played rook 1 d2. I think,
but then queen takes c4.
Knight d6
is a force, right? So he protected the e2 pawn for that. So queen c4 is not possible.
Yeah.
But white needs to have something concrete. Otherwise, let's say if I go queen a3, just for an example, do I have something right now? Yeah, it's clearly winning. So what is that? Rook d7 again. Yeah.
Yeah, and then if you take, I take. And then I win this bishop.
Correct. So
oh, even he played king g7. Good move.
Should have worked.
Yeah. You are saying that here itself he should have played this.
Yeah, I mean queen c4 maybe, but then now at least you have the choice, no?
But what about take and play this?
Same thing without f6, king h8.
Knight d7, bishop g5, right? I mean, what's happening? Like take. Queen takes, rook d7, takes.
Ah, this one is a draw without
here,
the c4 pawn.
King,
even earlier, king it would have
been possible. King g7, but then there is... Ah, then king f6, okay.
Sagar,
so, knight d... Yeah?
Pehle bhi ye same possible tha na?
Maybe this is drawn.
Hmm.
So, getting that c4 pawn was important. If without taking that c4 pawn, that endgame is lost.
Okay. So, well, what did he play? Let's
he played king g7.
1 minute 55 seconds. And 4 moves.
4 moves to make to reach 40th move.
Guys, what do you think? Maybe we can all guess the moves.
Oh, he played rook takes c5. But I think now Amruta, he may take on a3 and somehow Shankland may not have...
Yeah, somehow he has to... I think the moves may not be perfect until 40th move.
Yeah.
But even after that, if you get time, white pieces are really active.
I mean, the knight is beautiful.
Yeah.
But I think black will be able to hold this.
You think so? Right now he has 35 seconds. These 3 to 4 moves are also not so easy to survive.
Took on a3. Guys, after this, we will check Arjun's game, his victory over Max Warmerdam. Max is the second of Anish and has worked in the past with Anish and is a very strong grandmaster, I think about 2600. And Arjun managed to beat him. So we will be looking at that game. So please don't go away and stay with us because this time pressure leads to some...
Rookie fight. Suppose, I mean, I go with a simple thing. Rook e5 is possible. Natural moves come to the mind. Rook d8 or rook c8. One of the moves. With the idea of, you know, doubling the rook on the 8th rank.
Maybe and rook e5, g8. I go bishop g5, knight g5 and rook e7 maybe.
That's good. So then rook d8 or rook c8 with the idea of doubling. And rook g8 would be a mate.
Here and here, but anyway, he's taking, no? And then we'll also look at Mamed Yaro's game tomorrow. It's Dubo versus Vidit and Jordan versus Pragnananda. Thank you so much.
And what about Anish and Magnus?
He's taken on e5. He's played your move, and I think now this is going to happen. Knight g5 and rook e7. And then the game will end in a draw, Amruta. So maybe it was exciting, but now it's...
But there is a possibility of making a mistake until move 40th. Let's see. Aryan Mahindaru says, Sir, aaj mummy bhi dekh rahi hai stream. Today mummy hopefully wouldn't snatch the phone. No tension.
Okay, so this is what we discussed, Amruta. Knight g5, rook e7. Maybe he'll take with the rook.
Still, white will have some chances, huh, Sagar?
In classical games, 30-second increment is a lot of time.
Yeah, true.
And I think the players are able to, when the position is manageable, they are able to play well. And both the players have played pretty well. Also, but Shankland, I think, missed his opportunity. He was better.
Yeah, after such a beautiful sacrifice. The two things which I can see in this position, Sagar, are a pawn, that a pawn, and you know the knight, yeah, rook pawn. So if that a pawn becomes a monster, it's possible that even black could get a better position. But that is against black's weak king. So I think majorly it's going to be that kind of a war, and the game will not end in a draw.
Yeah. Anish versus Mamedyarov and Magnus versus Duda. Oh, Magnus versus Duda would be interesting. And also, Amrita, now rook d6 is a big idea. So you need to kill this rook. And so rook f5 will come to mind. This is the last couple of moves left now before time control. Pallav Doshi says, came to Sagar Bhai, long time no see. Yeah, Pallav, good to see you after a long time. Rook f5 has been played here.
Oh, he has played it, and it's forced right now in a way. The exchange.
Well, you have rook d7.
No,
check.
I mean, the rook exchange is going to happen anyway. Right?
Yes. Okay, let's go to the next game. Amrita, Mamedyarov versus Essipenko is one game that everyone said, let's.
No, but let's look at the game if it's going on, no, right now.
Which like, one?
Rappo versus Van Forest. What's the.
No, I.
40th move is done, yeah?
Rapport is winning. He's 2 pawns
yeah,
up.
Yeah, clearly winning.
No, I was just wanting to see this crazy opening or something. Mm-hmm. d4, knight f6, c4, e6. Mm-hmm. And guys, what does Mamedyarov do? Mamedyarov says, knight c3, Nimzo Indian. I don't like it. Knight f3, Bogo Indian. Queen's Gambit declined. Maybe Benoni. Maybe Queen's Indian. Don't like it.
Oh my god.
G3. Don't like bishop b4. A3. Don't like d5. So, what is Mamedyarov's zindagi? G4.
Whoa. Hats off to this guy, man. G4. Like, kaise dhunda?
Oh. And Essipenko didn't even touch the pawn. He just played d5 in the center. Because maybe Mamedyarov's idea was after you take on g4 to play e4. Attacking the knight and taking control of the center.
No, one tempo is such a strong center. You have a lot of competition.
I don't know if it is enough or not. But it's surely scary.
Exactly. G5. Psychologically, it's enough. Bishop g2, bishop g4. Check. King f1. Wow, is g4 going to become the new fashion, Sagar? No. Do you think? No, you didn't even think for a second.
No, it won't become a fashion. It's like one move and one game you can play, but not more. Look at this g6. I mean, Mamedyarov is such a refreshing player. He's able to play, and that's why he gets invited to such events. Of course, he's a very strong player, but everyone enjoys his chess.
Correct.
And then eventually the game ended in a draw. But this was the most exciting part of the game.
Like, guys, G4. A question for you. Would you like to play such an opening? G4. Here, I mean. How many of you would like to go for G4? Hey, why don't you do a poll, please?
I still have the Anish poll going on.
Huh, so that's over. End poll. Sandeep Kulkarni, thank you for your super sticker.
Yeah, thank you, Sandeep.
And the poll is coming, guys. Vignesh says anything unconventional is fun.
Okay. So, going to the game of Arjun Arigesi against...
poll dala?
Yes, I have put the poll. So, Arjun was playing with black against Max. C4, E6, G3, D5, BG2, Knight F6, Knight F3, Bishop E7, D4, Castles, And we have the same position that was reached between Magnus and Anish Giri today.
Hmm.
Magnus had played what move, Amruta?
One second. Magnus played a4, no? No, 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 knight a3. Sorry. अरे सब की मेमोरी तुम्हारे जितने थोड़ी
एंड देन इट वेंट लाइक टेक बिशप d7 एंड सो ऑन राइट सो हियर अर्जुन इज ओपोनेंट मैक्स प्लेड qc2 व्हिच इज द मोस्ट नॉर्मल मूव एंड b5 व्हिच इज व्हाट नेपो प्लेड एंड a4 बिकॉज़ नाइट e5 इज व्हाट मैग्नस हैड प्लेड इन दैट गेम बट a4 इज द मेन मूव एंड आई ऑलवेज लव टू आस्क दिस क्वेश्चन. By the way, b4 is the correct move, but why not to play c6 here? Let's see who can find the right answer. You know it?
I thought I knew it, but then now that you're surprised, I think I don't know.
Your laughter so quickly, because it's not like so simple that you can laugh.
Then I would not know it. I would have messed it up. But let's look at the poll.
Oh, we didn't see Vidit's game, no, Amruta?
No, not yet.
We'll see Vidit's game after this.
By the way, do you like Shark G4? For that poll, yes, is 66%.
Oh.
It's leading. So it means people would like to play G4.
Very nice.
Awesome, guys. Oops.
Yes. A lot of you have... By the way, Arav Arora has made a beautiful suggestion. Take, and Queen E4, winning the rook, but losing the queen. So I take on AB, CB. A lot of people have found this. I guess it was the main suggestion here. Oh no, 95 you want to play. By the way, let me
first one with 95. No, Chinmay saying no. We liked Shark playing G4. I would not play it because I'll probably be lost after that. Shashank remembers this is the typical QGA trap.
No, it's not a typical one, no? Shashank, because there's a small difference there. Maybe you know it, but it's not a very typical one.
In fact, you asked the wrong question. Either way, Uday also said. So your question is slightly confusing. I do like his G4 move, but won't play myself. So liking Shark's G4 and whether you will play G4.
Yes, but my question was, do you like it or not only? I didn't want them to play. I think G4 is not...
You don't want them to play. Yeah. Because it's...
Okay, so the move here, by the way, is not knight e5 as all of you mentioned. Because if you go knight e5 here, which is very tempting, then I can block with knight d5. Hmm. Which is very, very normal.
And hence, you play first a takes b5, c takes b5. And now, if you play knight e5...
Same thing.
Is a problem, knight d5. So hence, you play a move where black cannot play knight.
So find the move for white now. Did you see this so quickly?
No, I actually saw knight e5 and then I realized it's a mistake because obviously you said, how did you find it? And then I realized, okay, it's not possible. So,
so by the way, all those who write kg5, remember it's knight on chessboard is N, starts with an N, so you have to write knight g5, ng5. Knight g5 is absolutely right. Good job done by Chaitanya Awadh, Pushkar Dere,
Mahesh S.A., Vomesh 1021, Pranshu Kumar, Rohan Bala Subramaniam, Siddesh, Mamba, Maharop Hussein, Shubham Deshpande.
Yeah. So you have to play here knight g5. Now knight d5 is impossible because of a checkmate here. So that is the reason why that is not going to work. So here instead of playing c6, which is a mistake, Arjun went b4. Now if you take on c4, there is bishop a6 followed by knight d7 and c5. That's the reason why he played knight fd2. Also very well known stuff here, Amruta. Knight d5, knight takes c4, c5. D takes c5, bishop c5, e4 was played, knight b6, and if you look at the timings, both have only spent 7 minutes and 9 minutes each, so they are in their prep, perhaps. knight bd7, a5 was played, and suddenly the knight seems to be trapped, Amrita.
Right. What? But it has to be something tactical, yeah, to save the knight. Let's, okay, got it.
Very interesting that the knight is completely trapped on b6 and yet Arjun is able to, you know, play this. Do you think that this was some preparation,
yes,
by Arjun?
Yes, I think so. Because if you have more than 1 hour 30 minutes, it's very hard to believe that it's not. And even if the exact position is not, like, you have prepared surrounding it.
So let me just pull our chess base board here and to show you how many games continued this way. This was Arjun's game after knight c4. He played c5, dc, bishop c5, e4. Only two games. Daniel Darda versus Kollers. Sorokin versus Hakobian. So two good players. Knight b6. Now after transposition.
A5. Yeah, bishop a6 is the only move.
Sorokin, Hakobian has seen this already, Amrita. And now you can't take here on a6 just as yet because of bishop f2 and you lose this c2 queen. So this is exactly what happened in Arjun's game as well. So let's follow it there. After a5, he went bishop a6, and after ab, he played rook c8.
Yeah, with the threat of bishop f2.
And now what a big blunder.
No, I can't believe it.
Yeah.
No, he didn't miss bishop f2, right? Or yeah. Did he think...
No, he just thought that it's okay for him. He had to go queen d1. Mm-hmm. And after, let's say, something like
bishop
f1, maybe b7 intermediate, yes, move to make a queen, rook c7.
Now bishop takes f1.
And I mean, I would love to take on b7 here. But then after knight b3, white is better. So that's the reason
just
why.
Just a moment, after knight b3, white is better.
Sorry, white
the
is
material
better.
Is two pieces for a rook. Ah, that's the reason. Got it.
And he stabilized it. So here you must go knight e5 when the position is extremely complicated and we are playing for all
yeah,
three
results.
Yeah,
basically on white's development. I mean, materially, if white is able to get out his pieces, white should be better. But it's not so easy because black's pieces are super active.
Yeah.
Okay. So what happened then? He played rook takes a6 in that position.
Yeah, he took here, Amrita.
And then bishop
and Arjun
f2,
said,
of course.
Thank you so much, Max. Because now what you have done is you've given me a c2. I guess what Max wanted to do, and maybe that was his plan, is after rook c2, he might have wanted to play this.
With the idea of queen, so knight.
But
no,
first
but then
I
rook
take,
c1 is a check, no?
Yeah, I take with a check, rook f1. You take here, knight f1, and then eventually you play knight b6 with the idea of knight a8, and you are
this is winning.
Holding. I mean,
so
you are winning.
Okay, king f2, he played.
He played king f2, I took
now
take
b
the
takes
queen.
A7.
He takes a7.
Knight b6. But nothing. What is the material currently? Rook and two pieces for a queen.
No. Two pieces only.
Ah.
Two pieces only. By the way, this bishop is trapped in a weird way.
Because the knight can't.
B6, queen c5, and he won this. Knight f3, and this is easy. Now he took here.
Oh.
Played here. And he resigned. Abhijit, thank you so much for your super chat. What a win, and by the way, such a blackout moment for Max Warmerda.
Yes.
I mean, how do you explain a move like rook takes a6 when you have queen d1? I mean, you could just move your king queen back. But once you take here, you think that, okay, I have one piece. I got my second piece. And now I'll get three pieces here, Amrita.
Hmm.
That could be a logic.
I know, but I think...
You're losing this pawn. You're losing that piece.
No, recently, as we know that over the board tournaments have been so less, that blackout moments are much more. Because whenever, even after exam we used to play, many times in a normal position, it was a blackout moment, right?
Yeah.
It was not just a loss. So that's maybe going to be a little common thing now. Max explained in his tweet. That's what Swapnil Agarwal is saying.
Sometimes the brain just doesn't work. That's what Max has said on his Twitter, and he just lost.
How old is Max, by the way?
Max is, I think, older than Arjun. Mm-hmm. He should be somewhere around 20s, but let's just see. Max Warmerdam. He is born in 2000, so he's 21 years old.
Very young still.
Okay. Going back to Vidit Gujarati's game, Amruta.
Let's go. I'll read a comment. Shashank Ashwat says, I have a feeling AG came on the wrong side of some world championship preparation from Magnus. He had unleashed 95 in game 2, but perhaps had knight a3 up his sleeve for another game, but didn't have to use it.
So but knight a3 is not a big surprise because it has been played before. But you know what they do at the highest level is that they will choose certain moves which they have never played and which has been played lesser, and hope that Anish has not revised it before his game.
Yes, and especially when it is sharp, revision matters.
So if Anish had seen this before the game, he would have remembered all the intricacies. But because he might have seen it maybe a month ago or a few months ago, then you tend to forget all the details of the opening, and then Magnus was able to take advantage. By the way, Vidit versus Caruana is the next game that we are having a look at. And Vidit playing the world number 4 now, who was world number 2 some time ago. But now Ding Lijian has and Alireza Firuja both have overtaken him.
Ayush Bankhede asks, Sagar sir, I want to make my English like you.
Maybe you can make it better than me.
How?
By learning it and by seeking help. And I think that's the most important thing to learn. You should ask people who are better than you to teach you. You ask me, I understand, but there must be surely people around you who could teach you and have time for that. Knight c3, c6, e3, knight bd7, queen c2, bishop d6, bishop d3, castles, e5. Oh, this reminds me of this world championship match. You know which one?
No.
Look at this. This is the very famous world championship. Let me see if anyone remembers it. Which world championship match witnessed this opening?
But tell me something, this e5, isn't it your preparation, Sagar? You had played it in many games. Am I right? Or
sorry?
Am I wrong? This preparation?
No, I haven't played this.
Or is it in some other line it was coming, e5 ideas?
Yeah, in d4 many times it does, but I'm not very sure.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, not Anand Topalov, no. Vishy match, but against whom? Let's see who remembers or who has followed it.
Ren and
Martin? Yeah, Ren and Martin I used to study when I was young. It's based on grammar. Yes, Vishy Gelfand. Amit Roy, you are absolutely right. Well done, Amit Roy is right. Anand versus Gelfand witnessed this. Awesome. And Amruta, if I have to just show you how many games have already reached this position after e4, then you can see it here on our chess base screen. E4 has been played 421 times, and in Anand versus Gelfand, if I am not mistaken, there used to be an insertion of a6 move, or maybe there is no here. Anand Gelfand World Championship 2012. Yeah, they played it many times against each other. Okay.
Oh, wow.
Or maybe not many times, but at least once. So e4, and then he took d. I want to just see how much was theory here. Knight e4, bishop e4, attacking h7, so h6. He played bishop e3, 94 games ed, bishop d4, knight f6, bishop f5, still has been played 19 times, queen a5, bishop c8, rook fc8, queen b3, nice choice by Vidit Amruta, because all the games are either drawn or white wins here. Mm-hmm. But all the games that white players have won have been against weaker opposition. Against Fabiano Caruana, he's very well prepared. Rook fd1, rook d8, king f1, knight b4, bishop c3, c6, knight d4, takes, takes. And this has now we reached finally a new position. This was played in Epishin versus Sifuentes para Sifuentes game. Parada. And then here Amruta, it was already a draw that they agreed to. So nothing much happened in this game of Vidit. It was theory and then eventually Vidit.
So it's good that he gets some time to rest. Yeah, yesterday has been very tiring, I believe. So Yash Dhawale says, miss your green wall behind. You mean the green curtain, yeah.
But anyway, people couldn't see it, right, Amruta?
They could. Ah, okay. Lot of people were in game. So have we checked all the games, Sagar? I think so, right?
Surya's game is left. So let's have a quick look at that. He played against Lucas Van Forest.
And just a quick update on Mamedaro. Achha, you've started this. Let's see this first.
Yeah, let's look at this. Again, Catalan. C5. C6, knight e5, bd7, a3, cd, knight c4. Very typical line. Ooh, knight h5. And now, everything starts going crazy.
Speak, yeah? Speak. The knight on g2 is trapped, the knight on e7 was trapped. But I like black's position as of now.
Yeah, but it ended in a draw.
Yeah.
What? Once again, if you think about it, Amruta, this game could also be like super prep.
Really?
And the thing is that this is what people feel like in chess. It's become a bit dull because players come very well prepared with all the opening ideas. My question is that did they find this on the board? I doubt. I have my doubts here, Amruta. What do you think? Like, let's just have a quick look.
Must be majority of the game might be preparation.
So bishop d7, knight a3, cd. This has already been played 769 times. Queen b3, queen c7. By the way, guys, this what I'm using here is Chessbase 16 along with live database. Knight h5 has been played 27 games. The players who have played with black are Wesley So, Hari Krishna, Savian. Good players with white. It has been Nepo, Ponkratov, Nielsen. Take on c6, take on f4, take on e7, take on g2. Rook a c1, Nepo versus Wesley So, queen c5, queen seven. Abhijit Gupta has played this at some point. Mm-hmm. Or someone else, I don't know, some Gupta. King e7, queen g2, bishop c6, queen h3.
Ah, this is a new one. But look, as I said, I think most of the important part of the game was
play. Preparation so and
know it kind of.
Here they exchanged and it was a draw.
No, very true. Saurabh Badai asked, Sagar Bhai, I want to increase my focus and concentration. How chess can help me achieve that?
I think when you play chess online as well or wherever, just try to switch off everything around you and focus on that. So if you are playing on the laptop, just keep one tab open. If you are playing it on the phone, try to switch off everything else and then play it. And you will see that if you are completely immersed in the game, it is some sort of meditation because you are just following the moves and it will help you to improve your concentration immensely. But if you play chess with all the distractions around, with your mobile phones, music playing, there is also someone at the door, you have to go there and so many things disturbing you, it won't help to
increase. Like the hyper focus while playing chess is very important. Only then you can.
Yeah. So, by the way,
Ruparel has asked, I would like to be able to use my chess base more effectively. Any suggestions? I think you have made a video.
Yes, I have a video. Chess base 16 plus mega 21 is what I had made. I want to make short clips as well of little features of chess base, which I'll try to do. But that video has a very nice summary of everything, and also there is a PowerPoint presentation in that. So guys, if any of you want to make use of it professionally, it is used by all the strong players out there, and you too can get it. Chessbase 16 plus mega database, it's the first link in the description. Check it out. You can also get the Chessbase India premium chess set. It's also a link in the description. They are very nice chess pieces and you can get them there. You can also get Vedika's chocolates, very nice ones. They are available in 3 flavors. Vedika is a budding young entrepreneur, our good friend, also sister of Vidit Gujarati. She sells very nice homemade chocolates in chess themed style on the cover, and she has three flavors, classic, orange, and choco chip. So you can find that link as well. And by the way, look at this beautiful playing venue at the Tata Steel. It is amazing.
Very nice.
Someday we want to go to 2 events which we haven't yet been to. One is Tata Steel and the other one is Gibraltar.
Right, no, then we can say 3.
Which is the third one?
For me, it is Norway.
Norway chess. Ah, that's also something which we haven't gone yet. But this is so nice, and you know, they have only used small space because there are only 2 sections. This can even open up, I guess, further, where there is the challenges section when it's played, and it's very nice. You know, the spectators are waiting there and there's nice pictures. Alina Lamy used to take some great pictures. So again, you can see here how there is challengers in one and the masters in another section. Players are moving around. There are no spectators. There are a couple of arbiters, all COVID restrictions. Yesterday, there were some pictures that I had collected from yesterday as
well. Lennart, right?
Yeah, Lennart is taking some very nice pictures. By the way, for all those who missed yesterday's stream, our November's fund for memberships is going to Shreya Hiparagi, who's a young talent from Maharashtra. She comes from a small village near Sangli, where a family of 17 people live together. Her father is a teacher and earns for the family, and there are also his brothers who work in the farm. It's very difficult for Shreya to sustain her chess career. She's a huge talent. She has some amazing achievements to her credit, like a lot of medals at national and Asian level, and she has made the country proud on numerous occasions, and that is why all the money that we have collected, close to 60,000 rupees, will be given to her for her chess improvement and chess betterment, so that she can be felicitated more often at the railway station when she comes back victorious from tournaments. All of this is possible because of you guys who have become members. So a big thank you to all of you. And before we call it a night tonight, let's just have some quick update.
Yeah, one question from Dan Ruparel is, any interest in visiting the US Chess Club in
absolutely.
St. Louis?
Absolutely. That's another place. In fact, US is a country we have never visited. So it's very surprising because there's a lot of chess activity going on there. We spent a lot of time in Europe playing tournaments, covering events. But US, we have never been, and we really want to go to St. Louis Chess Club. There's so much chess out there. We would love to be there.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Anil Kumar, for your super chat.
Abhiraj Ratna asked, why should we buy database? This is also available on Leeches for free. I'm genuinely wondering, this is not a troll or hate comment.
Yes. So in general, it, first of all, you will see that over here you have more games, I believe, in the mega database, which are of high quality. Secondly, there are annotated games. Like, for example, let's just give you an example here. If I'm looking at a certain opening, then I have I don't know, maybe let's say here, 95, I go to reference. And I try to see some games. And if you go to this section here, you will see that there are games which are annotated. So here, if I put this up, this one is annotated by Boris Avruk, like this. And so many players you will find. So that is one thing, more than 100,000 games annotated. Secondly, when you work inside Chessbase, you can save your databases. You can work very well. You have the strong engines here to work with. So it's actually a very... It's a very, very professional robust and nice way to work. And also if you're playing tournaments, is the best way to prepare. Because that's how everyone does it. And yeah, that's my suggestion.
One question by Insanely Insane is, in general question, how to avoid distraction while studying? Do you have an answer for that?
Yeah, I mean, there are two approaches. One is to change internally. The other one is to change externally. I guess it's much easier to start externally to reduce the number of things that distract you externally. So many times we see there are many distractions in our environment. Firstly, there could be a bed around you where you feel like sleeping. You see there's mobile phone around you, which you feel like seeing messages. And if you are able to get rid of all of these distractions, maybe a very good place, like when I was studying for my CA, I found going to a library was a very nice change of pace, because there I didn't feel as distracted as, let's say, in my bedroom, where every few minutes I would feel like going to sleep. So that is externally you can change your environment. I guess internally it has got to a lot with whether you enjoy what you are doing or not. If you are truly curious about certain things, then you should enjoy it. And I guess it's not easy, but
yeah,
when you like something you do, you focus.
Yeah, I think so. If I have to put it in one quote, I would say determination avoids distraction.
Mm-hmm. Chaitanya Awad, no Chessbase 17 will most likely come at the end of this year. So not anytime soon.
Joy says, I watch CBI clips in between office meetings when meetings get boring.
That's not how you stay focused. That's how he gets distracted. Tizia Kumar said, I had bought Chessbase 16 a year ago. It's awesome. Thank you, Tizia. That's good to know. Can anyone tell results of Indian players, including Anish? Kiran Purohit, Vidit draw against Karuana. Ganguly draw against Lucas Van Forest. Arjun beat Max Wormerdam. Pragnananda drew with Duda. And Anish Giri lost to Magnus Carlsen. Should we do a roundup? Sanat Pednekar. Okay. Let's do a roundup. So, very, very quick roundup today because we've covered a lot. Magnus Carlsen versus Anish Giri. This was, I believe, the game of the day.
Mm-hmm.
It started off with the Catalan, the open Catalan. Magnus surprised Anish with knight a3. And Anish was in his preparation till a certain point, but then all of a sudden, he played this move queen d5 and Magnus sacrificed an exchange with rook takes c6 and then knight e5. And eventually the position did look around equal had Anish gone back knight b6, but he played knight d5. And after rook b1, bishop d5, Magnus was all over Anish. The last chance for Anish in this game was to take on d5 with the queen and then try to snatch the pawn on a2 when white would take on a4. But he took on d5 with the pawn, and when Magnus had chopped it off the pawn on b7, it was quality over quantity, because now beautiful rook, beautiful knight, beautiful bishop, queen coming in, king is weak, and Magnus was so clinical in converting this position, Amruta. It was phenomenal.
Totally.
And after queen d8, dc5, what a move, exchanging the queens, even though he was exchanged down. Then came knight at 6 check, pawn pushed to c6, pawn pushed to c7, and then bishop b2, king f1. Also, he played very quietly at this point, and then finally he cashed in And with 2 points up, Amruta was saying he will go on for a long time, but Anish resigned and Magnus Carlsen got his win. Well, in that way, he's moving towards his goal of 2,900. I guess today he might have regained three to four ELO points. Vidit Gujarati against Fabiano Caruana was a very well-known line in the semi-slav, and this was all played before, so nothing was particularly new here. And after take they took here, it just petered out into a very quick draw. So maybe for Vidit it was a very good result because he drew with a very strong player, and also yesterday was a long game, as Amruta said, so he gets time to recover. While for Caruana, he had black pieces, and a draw is never bad. Pragnananda versus Jan Sistov Duda was another game where Duda would be happy that he managed to equalize out of the opening, but Pragnananda would be happy that he was able to get a draw against Duda. You know, the same idea of D5 and E5 took place, but I mean, Prag seemed to have some bit of things going his way, but Duda always had things under control. And eventually, the game ended in a draw after Rook B7. The players exchanged pieces and it was drawn. Jordan versus Rapport is right now going on. Rapport is completely winning. He will win the game. Mamediaro versus Essipenko is worth mentioning because after D4, NF6, C4, E6, the most weird move happened in this position.
68% liked it.
G4. And that is where this game was very exciting, but it ended in a draw. Karjakin versus Dubov, the grudge match, but actually there was no grudge on the board. They just played very simple chess. It was actually Dubov's Tarash. We've already been speaking about it a lot. Dubov has popularized it. Here, black is a pawn down, but well, he has great compensation. And here, they quickly agreed to a draw. Shankland versus Grandelius Nils. I think Shankland had great chances to get an advantage in this game, but he messed it up, and in the end, it was a draw. In the challengers section, we had Mursin, who has won his second game in a row. Amruta, yesterday he won. Today also he's beaten Polina Shuvalova. We have Surya Ganguly, who drew his game against Lucas Van Forest. And once again, Ganguly showed excellent preparation. This was all played before, and he managed to equalize without too much difficulties, and the game ended in a draw. Guen Thai Dan Van beat Bier Jonas. Max Wormerdam just blanked out against Arjun Erigesi, and this was the moment when things went wrong. After a5, bishop a6, ab6, rook c8, the only move to stay in the game is queen d1, but he played rook a6, I don't know why, and after bishop f2, he lost the queen, and Arjun converted it without too many difficulties. Moritzi Mark Andrea drew with Jumabayev. Daniel Darda is still playing against Rowan Vogel, and Erwin Lamy, after his loss yesterday, has won his game against Zuziner, so he is on 1 out of 2. That was the recap. I hope you enjoyed it. And Amruta,
yes,
what have we got? Any
No, sorry, I was zoned out. Looking at the updates, it was great for me also to know and to follow that. 1.7 for Magnus, that's what we have.
3.7 today, he lost two points yesterday. So it comes overall 1.7.
Totally 3.7.
So he reaches 2867.
Yeah.
Step by step, 33 points to go. Will he do it?
I think so.
Lot of people say statistically impossible, but
especially sometimes some blackout moments are really good for you. Like yesterday he missed d4, that makes him more alert and more determined.
You know, that's the thing about tough situations. It really makes some players very strong, and makes them determined, while it really makes some players feel like, oh, I'm not in good form, you know, I missed that move. So you have to choose what you feel, and I think Magnus will do this 2900 stuff. I know it's very difficult, statistically almost impossible, because you're going to draw games and gaining points in any tournament is really tough.
Yes.
Like in this tournament, he has to score like 10 out of 13 to gain like couple of Elo points or something like that. So tough.
Yeah, but it's Magnus.
Yes, it's Magnus. That's the point.
Yeah.
Vidit also gained around, I think, few Elo points. He's now up to 273, 2.5 or something. So he's like 2733. He's world number 20. I believe this is the highest he has ever been. Good start for him. Okay. So we will call it a night, Amruta. Is there anything left to do?
No, Ronak Sodhani says shave or no shave poll. Yesterday, I'm telling you 57% of the people said.
Yeah, no. I'll decide, Amruta. Let not the chat decide.
Sagar is scared. Okay, so tomorrow we'll have the poll, okay?
Yes, for sure. We'll have it later. I'll shave it now. And so, guys, good night. Take care and see you all tomorrow with the third round. I hope you enjoyed. Please do write some comments if you enjoyed the commentary. We'll come earlier tomorrow so that we can cover more games. Until then, take care. Bye-bye. See you.